हॉरिजॉन्टल एनालिसिस ऑल्सो कॉल्ड कंपैरेटिव एनालिसिस और ट्रेंड एनालिसिस रिफर्स टू स्टडिंग द बिहेवियर ऑफ इंडिविजुअल फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट आइटम्स ओवर सेवरल अकाउंटिंग पीरियड्स। द एनालिसिस ऑफ ए गिवन आइटम में बी फोकस ऑन ट्रेंड्स इन द एब्सोल्यूट अमाउंट ऑफ द आइटम और ट्रेंड्स इन परसेंटेजेस। द फॉर्मूला यूज टू कैलकुलेट एब्सोल्यूट अमाउंट चेंज इज करंट अमाउंट माइनस प्रीवियस अमाउंट। And the formula used to calculate percentage change is current amount minus previous amount divided by previous amount into 100. Here current amount in the sense the value in a current year and the previous amount is the value in a previous year. So here you have an items of a balance sheet, so profit and loss account for the years 2008 to 2012. So as 2008 we don't have any base year. We start calculating from 2009. So in 2009, our current year is 2009, and previous amount is amount in 2008. So in Excel, we use equal to sign to write a formula. So equal to, then we need a current year value. Current year value is in 2009, value is 7648. Select this and minus 2008 value and click enter. So you got a minus 374, that is the absolute change is minus 374. So once you calculate for 1 year, simply hold this. When a cursor shows a plus sign, drag on to right, automatically the equation is calculated for the 4 years. Now similarly drag down to all items. That's it. Now the absolute change of horizontal analysis has been done for 4 years and for all the items. Next we see how to calculate the percentage change. Excel follows operator precedence in the sense any items which are division, multiplications are performed first, additions and subtractions are performed next. So here we need is first we need to calculate current amount minus previous amount. So here minus is a second precedence operator. So to make Excel calculate these two first, we put this within a brackets. Now this equals to open a bracket, then current year value, current year income, that is 7648 minus previous year income, that is 8002, and close the bracket, then divided by previous year income into 100. You are multiplying this with 100 because we want it in a percentage. So the absolute change is minus 4.66%. Once you calculate for 1 year, simply drag for the next 3 years, and now drag for all the items. The ratios has been calculated. So to make this, just format cells number with the 2 decimals, and you can prefer negative values in red. So negative values in red, okay. So here we got a negative values in red. As we are doing it for absolute, that is a trend analysis, in the horizontal analysis we are trying for a trend where 1 year is projected on the next years. So it is advisable to have a bar graphs. So we will see how to calculate a bar graph on a percentage items. So select the percentage items, go to insert, or we go for a column graphs, insert a 2D column graph, and here is your graph. So year 1 it is negative, now year 2 it is high, then high and low. So when your data is year on year, it is always advisable to go for a bar graphs. This is how simple to calculate horizontal analysis in Excel. So similarly, as you have drawn for graph for one, you can draw graphs for all the items.